What is a quarter of the Earth's population today? Well, it's everyone in China and in India. And I complain about the traffic here in Jerusalem. Shalom and greetings from Jerusalem. Traffic-filled Jerusalem. Now, honestly, if there was anything nice about the shutdowns, shutdown except for essential things like shopping for food, but if there was anything nice about the shutdowns during COVID, it was that the streets were empty of cars. Oh, it was so easy to get to wherever I needed to go. To go shopping for food, of course, nothing else. Well, life is back to normal. And a 5-minute drive to and through a major intersection, a traffic light, can take up to 15 minutes. So if you're stuck in traffic, sit back and watch or listen to today's video, Weapons of Today, which is part of our series on end times. We're in part 2, called The Tribulation, and we are studying the fourth seal. It's not easy to listen to, and I'm not so sure it's easy to see, but I'm doing the best I can. We have to recognize that the time is getting closer when the wrath of God will know no bounds. And admittedly, it's hard to conceive of his signing the death certificate of 1/4 of the Earth's population. But friends, soon we're going to see even greater numbers consigned to death because of God's judgment on the wicked. Remember, God will never be mocked. Whatever we sow, all of our rebellion, well, that we will reap. Galatians chapter 6, verse 7. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. So what are you sowing, friends? As death and Hades fulfill their assignment to take out 1/4 of the Earth's population, not only will the number of dead be so astounding, so will the ways they accomplish their goals. That's a lot of people at one time. So let's remind ourselves of Revelation chapter 6 and verse 8. So I looked, and behold, a pale horse, and the name of him who sat on it was Death, and Hades followed with him. And power, authority, was given to them over 1/4 of the earth to kill with sword, with hunger, with death, and by the beasts of the earth. That's their assignment, and they will fulfill it. Now, we've seen other writers use the sword and famine, so we want to consider the weapons of death and beasts of the earth that might be used to kill so many people so easily and so quickly. It's hard to wrap our minds around it, isn't it? Now, the combination of technology and AI, which you know is artificial intelligence, has created weapons that can easily wipe out entire nations. And you know, not more than 10 years ago, we were watching movies and we watched these weapons in Hollywood's adventure movies, and we marveled at the ingenuity. But what we didn't realize at that time was that these marvels were just prototypes of what is now in our military arsenals. We couldn't have believed it, but somebody did. So let's talk about robotic soldiers or robo-soldiers. Remember the Bionic Man? We loved seeing what he could do with that robotic arm. What about Superman and all of his special abilities? Amazing. But today, those incredible superheroes are not just in our imagination. As I said, they are facts on the ground today. America is not the only country that has been developing robotic soldiers. And whatever human beings can do, these soldiers can do a whole lot better. So just consider the benefits of having robots fighting our battles instead of our sons and our daughters and our husbands. While they are killing the enemy, destroying the enemy, they are saving other lives. Interesting, huh? Here's a great example of today's robot soldiers. Not able to fight, they can also dance.
You broke my heart, 'cause I couldn't dance. You didn't even want me around. And now I'm back to let you know I can really shake them down.
Drones. Even our children play with drones today. But in the hands of the army, they are a strategic weapon. Today's drones are invisible to lasers and thus perfect not only for gathering intelligence, but also to kill. And then there's something called EMP, electromagnetic pulse. Now, EMP is at the top of the list for the ease of use and the extent of destruction. So, what is it? Well, EMP is a short burst of electromagnetic energy. That's hard to say. Say it three times. From a variety of sources, including nuclear. A nuclear bomb could set it up. High altitude nuclear detonations and electromagnetic bombs can generate EMP. Now listen to me. That has the potential to damage or destroy electronic devices over huge areas, nations. A 1.4 megaton bomb launched about 500 miles above Kansas. I don't know how you get up that high, but just listen, would destroy most of the electronics that were not protected, listen, in the entire United States. The following is an article written in 2003 by the Washington State Department of Health. Their suggestions of potential damage pales considering the speed of technology since that date. So consider what can happen and will happen. Damage to electronic equipment. That means computers, satellites, radios, radar receivers, traffic lights. It will cause a failure of semiconductive chips. What's that for? Which will destroy industrial processes, railroad networks, power and phone systems, even access to water supplies. Commercial computer equipment just simply wiped out. Radar and electronic warfare equipment, microwave, UHF, VHF, HF, I don't know what any of that means, communication, and television equipment. I'm still going. What about cars with electronic ignition systems and ignition chips are also vulnerable? And here we're being pushed, get electronic cars, EMP, wipe them out. What about railroad tracks, large antennas, pipes, cables, wires in buildings, and even metal fencing? So friends, stop. Stop whatever you're doing. Just stop and consider what would happen if everything you're using right at this moment suddenly ceases to work. Just like that. And everything you depend on for the rest of your day, make it plural, days, is suddenly not available. The result is beyond inconvenient or even chaotic. But remember, the motivation is death and destruction. And that's why we want to pray for peace in our hearts while we have an urgency in our mind to warn others of what is coming. Remember, the tribulation, going through the tribulation, is a choice. Decisions determine destiny. Standing with Israel. Thank you for standing with Novea Ministries. It is so important to hear from you, just to know that we're reaching people, because it's not simply me reaching you to pray for Israel, but it's you reaching other people, especially Israel. And wherever you are, there are Jewish people there. And if not, start praying for them. Start praying that you will have the opportunity to begin to minister to Jewish people wherever you are. And of course, we always solicit, we always covet your prayers, because here in Jerusalem, we're on the very front line. And it is so good to talk to the Jewish people, my brethren. I don't always use the word tribulation, but I will use the word Jacob's trouble, because that's an Old Testament word that most Jewish people, they've heard about, but they don't know what it means. And now you can tell them what it means. And why it is because of rebellion against God. It's that simple. It's that simple. He's a good father. He's a righteous judge. And he must punish sin. The difference between our earthly fathers and our heavenly fathers is when he punishes, it's for eternity. It's for eternity. So, thank you for watching. Thank you for standing with us in support. And with that, I do say, Lehitraot, Shalom from Jerusalem.